I'm Rick Emerson. Welcome back to Outlook Portland on Portland CW. I'm joined by Russ Belville from the Oregon chapter of the National Association for the Reform of Marijuana Laws, as well as Socko, the Prohibition puppet. Socko, you were making an interesting point during the break.
I was asking if Russ really believes that there is a civil right which entitles you to engage in behavior which can be shown to be destructive to yourself or society or your family.
That's a good question, Socko. I think to address that right, we would have to look at the 18th and the 21st Amendments to the Constitution. It took a constitutional amendment to prohibit alcohol because many people felt morally strong that we shouldn't, felt morally that we shouldn't be using alcohol, and that proved to be a complete disaster. Then we had the 21st Amendment that repealed that prohibition. That suggests to me that if we have the right to drink, that means we have a right to be intoxicated. And so it's ludicrous in my estimation to allow people to use the much more harmful drug, alcohol, when we don't give them the chance to use the safer drug, marijuana.
Where do most Oregonians seem to stand on the issue of marijuana reform, marijuana law reform? Is it something that is different than the rest of the United States in terms of outlook, in terms of opinion?
Absolutely. If you were to take a line and draw it from, say, Seattle, Washington, to just north of San Diego, and from that line across to the Pacific Ocean, you would find the most marijuana-friendly place in the world, the west coast of the United States. A Zogby poll was just released this last week that showed that while nationally support for legalizing marijuana stands at about 44%, in the West Coast, the support for legalizing marijuana stands at 58%. Nearly 6 in 10 people on the West Coast believe that marijuana should be taxed and regulated like alcohol.
Aren't we talking about a different drug than the drug of 30 or 40 years ago, though?
This is the old not your father's Woodstock weed argument, the idea that marijuana is now 10 times or 20 times more potent. It's just not true. The marijuana today is slightly more potent, maybe a factor of 2 in that, but that really doesn't matter. Marijuana is not like alcohol, where if you drink a beer, a 12-ounce beer versus 12 ounces of liquor, you're going to have an extremely different reaction. Marijuana is self-titrating, which just means as you use it, you can immediately sense how you feel. So if you have less potent marijuana, you smoke a lot of it and get high. If you have very potent marijuana, you smoke very little of it and get high. And from a health perspective, considering that the smoke is the most damaging part of marijuana, more potent marijuana could actually be more healthy for you.
From the vantage point of NORML, either in the Oregon chapter or nationally, what is the next step? What is the next stage? Is there a sense that the current administration will have a different tack than the Clinton administration or the Bush administration?
Well, it's important to understand that NORML's nonpartisan on these issues because when it comes to the drug war, both sides have, Democrats and Republicans, have been pretty odious on this. President Clinton arrested 4.5 million marijuana smokers. President Bush arrested 5.4 million, so not a lot of difference there. We feel that the major move is not going to be at the federal level for quite a few years for many reasons, people feeling afraid to look soft on drugs and so on. Our focus now is on state-level initiatives that are continuing to build grassroots support for marijuana law reform, and maybe sometime soon at the national level.
And on the opposing side, how do you see the approach unfolding?
Well, the battle against medical marijuana has been lost. They don't realize it yet, but the American people, in poll after poll after poll, no matter where you survey them, the support for medical marijuana is in the 70 to 80% range. Michigan just passed medical marijuana. It got more votes than Barack Obama did and passed in every single county, even the ones that voted for John McCain. So that battle is over. Their only shot left for the prohibitionists is to continue to play the what about the children card, and even that's starting to fade.
I'd like to thank my guest, Russ Belville, from the Oregon chapter of NORML, the National Association for the Reform of Marijuana Laws, as well as Socko, the prohibition puppet.
I don't like my makeup.
We'll fix it in post. Don't forget, if you have an idea for an upcoming episode, guest, or topic, you can always email. It's OutlookPortland, all one word, OutlookPortland@yahoo.com. I'm Rick Emerson. If you find me even remotely amusing, you can always listen to me Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. on AM 970, The Talker. Insert trademark catchphrase here, and we'll see you next time right here on Outlook Portland on Portland CW.